Looking for something to spice up your dishes? Stay tuned because our home cooks are offering something new with their flavorful recipes. Chicken braised in ripe tomatoes and wine. Homecook Roselle Rodriguez shows us how to make this tasty dish.
Hi, this is Roselle Rodriguez from Kaintarigal, and today I'm going to share my recipe of kinamatisang manok. Let's start by marinating the chicken. First, I need the juice of 5 calamansi. I'm going to cut it in half and squeeze it on the chicken. I am using 1 kilo of boneless chicken thigh. You may also use other chicken parts that you prefer. I'm done slicing my calamansi in half. Let's now squeeze them on the chicken. You may also use lemon, but I still prefer calamansi since this is a Filipino dish. Add 3 tablespoons of fish sauce. And of course, some black pepper. Give it a good mix and it's done! Set this aside while we prepare our other ingredients. I'll start with 1 medium-sized white onion. You may also use the red one, but I prefer the white for this recipe because it's sweeter. It will complement the tangy tomatoes. Now I'm going to mince 5 cloves of garlic. Next up is our very important ingredient, which are 5 very ripe tomatoes. Make sure they're ripe because ripe tomatoes have more juice in it. This is approximately 300 grams of tomatoes. I've actually done this with 8 tomatoes, but it will be more sour, so I had to add more sugar to lessen the acidity. Next is the fresh oregano. Just roll the leaves and then cut it into strips. You may substitute 1 teaspoon of dried oregano if fresh is not available. Last but not the least, the leeks or puchay. Just remove the roots and then slice the white part thinly. I'm going to use this for sauteing. I'll join it along with the white onions. But I'm also going to use the green part, so I'm going to chop it also. Now let's fry the chicken. I use 1/2 cup canola oil. As you can see, I made sure that my oil is very hot before frying. I'm going to fry these until it's half cooked because I'm still going to boil these afterwards. Now, in the same pan and oil that I fried my chicken, I'm going to saute my onions and leeks. When the onion turns translucent, add the garlic. Once I see that the garlic starts to brown, I add the tomatoes. I'm adding salt so that it will release more flavor. After the tomato, add the fresh oregano. Just continue sauteing this until the tomatoes become mushy. I'm gonna help my tomatoes get mushy faster by slightly pressing it with the back of my spoon. Add 1/2 cup of sweet cooking wine, let it boil, and the alcohol will eventually evaporate. I love using sweet cooking wine because I don't feel the need to add sugar. It's time to add the chicken and all of its juices. I am now adding 2 tablespoons of oyster sauce for that slight umami flavor. Let me taste it. And yes, everything is balanced. It's salty, sweet, and a little bit tangy. Add some pepper, and you can see here that the sauce has already reduced. Smells so good! Lastly, add the cherry tomatoes and the leeks. This dish definitely looks like Christmas with all the red and greens. I wish you could smell it from here. The smell is divine! Thanks for watching and have a nice day!
Get creative with your rice dishes with this easy Cebu-style steamed rice recipe by Stan Feleo.
Hi, this is Stan. Today we're going to make Cebu-style steamed rice and garlic chili sauce. First, we need 50 grams of bird's eye chili, half of which we will remove the seeds. And we need 100 grams of garlic. We mince both. In a frying pan, add oil. and saute your garlic and chili. Add black pepper, salt, sugar, soy sauce, and vinegar. Once cool, place in a jar of your choice. And there you have your garlic chili sauce. For the steamed rice, you start 250 grams of shrimp. Remove the shells and the head, add oil. Add hot water and let it simmer for 5 minutes. You need one onion diced and 4 cloves of garlic diced. Take 500 grams of pork shoulder and remove the skin. But don't throw it away, we're going to use it to flavor the stock. In a large stock pot, add oil, add your onions, your garlic, pork skin, and your pork. Add fish sauce, white pepper, add your shrimp broth, add more hot water, add your shrimp cube, frozen peas, add your shrimp, and your cornstarch slurry. Add sesame oil, and there you have it. Your Cebu-style steamed rice. Don't forget to pair it with your garlic chili sauce. Enjoy!
Usually served during special occasions. Check out this Crispy Pork Kare-Kare by Chef Patrick Paragas.
Hi, good day everyone. This is Chef Patrick Paragas. And today we'll be making my specialty of crispy kare-kare. So these are the ingredients that you can see right now that we will be using for our cooking demo. So first of all, this is the crispy pork belly, as you can see. And then for our sauce, we will be using the garlic. We will be using onion, red onion, and then flour, butter, peanut butter, and then this is the stock from the pork belly that we made, and then annatto seeds, and then for the garnish, we will be using chopped walnuts, and then to pair up for our kare-kare, we will be using bagoong. Okay. So for our vegetables, we will be using talong, sitaw, and then pechay.
Hi guys, so we're back again. And right now, we have already prepared the necessary components that we need for our crispy kare-kare. So, we're ready to plate, guys.
This pasta dish made with spicy seafood and homemade kare-kare sauce is sure to be the talk of your next potluck party.
Hi, I am Tai Laguo, a mom of two and an entrepreneur. Today, I am going to share a kare-kare recipe with a twist. Kare-kare is a Filipino dish that is traditionally cooked using oxtail in peanut sauce served with bagoong alamang. But in this recipe, I am going to use seafood. For the pasta, this will be mixed with the spicy kare-kare sauce, my take on the Pinoy-style spicy peanut butter noodles. And this is my version of the spicy seafood kare-kare pasta. Let's start! For the annatto oil, heat the oil in a pan. Sauté the garlic, onions, ginger, lemongrass, siling labuyo until fragrant. Now it's time to add the prawn's head. Squeeze the head so the juice will come out and let it simmer until it turns orange. Put the annatto seed, then turn off the stove and leave it for 10 minutes. Strain everything and set aside. We are going to use this in frying our seafood and making the kare-kare sauce. Next step is to cook the seafood. First, put annatto oil and saute some garlic and bagoong alamang in the same pan that we used in making the annatto oil. Add the squid until it's cooked. Set aside. Repeat this with the mussels, crab, and prawns. saute the onions, garlic, chili picante or siling haba, and red chili pepper or siling labuyo in annatto oil. Add the broth from the mussel and simmer for 5 minutes. Add patis to taste. Add the coconut cream, peanut butter, ground cashew, and toasted rice. Let it simmer for another 10 minutes. We are done with the seafood, pasta, and kare-kare sauce. Now it's time to combine them all. You can garnish the pasta with cashew nuts and chili picante.
From chicken to seafood recipes, there's always something for everybody. Catch next week's episode as home cooks share more exciting recipes here on Potluck.